What are we doing? One of the single most important programs we have is teaching everybody to use electricity. How do you use it? When is it most expensive? Because under our contracts with Progress Energy, we don't pay the same price every hour. 1 hour a month makes up our total cost of electricity. If you look at this chart, the yellow bars on the bottom are our plants. That's the output from our plants. If you work across the chart to the left, and along the bottom is hours, and along the top would be how fast your meter is spinning. And if you look at midnight on a summer day, there's not a lot of energy being used. So we're down pretty low. It gets around 3 o'clock in the morning. It gets even low. It gets even lower than our plants are operating. But we're in a hot summer day. So as people start waking up around 5, 6, 7, 8, power starts increasing. They start cranking up more plants on the Progress Energy system. Power costs are increasing. When we get to the top of that chart, when Progress Energy has the highest what we call peak demand, that 1 hour every month makes up 50% of our power supply. So our job every month is to find that 1 hour. And what you see that bite at the top is what we call demand side management. Standing demand side management program that uses generation and load management switches to control water heaters and generators. This program saved power agency $40 million. And it saves the city of Washington, and it saves every customer that participates in this program money also. And I think the staff can talk to you about that a little bit more in more detail. But this is probably the most important program that we have to control costs at both the power agency level, at the city level, and at the individual customer level that you can see results every single month. So what is it, you know, and I won't belabor this, this can get a little complicated. But our peak charge is $12.56. Our energy charge is 4.5 cents. So to the extent we can eliminate that $12.56 charge, we can save that every month. In the summertime, that's about $3 million a month, $3.5 million a month. And I've already talked about what else is here: peak shaving generated for commercial and industrial customers, demand control, working with the customers. We know your commercial and industrial customers are jobs, and we work very closely with them, very closely with the staff to make sure that their costs are as low as possible. And then finally, load management switches for air conditioners and water heaters saves money. I think that's all I have, Mary. Do you want to open it up to questions?
Yeah, let's do that. I know there was a lot to say at the end, and I'm prepared to roll right into Keith's presentation, but Keith, if you could just hold on. And let's. Has anyone got a question specific to the Electric Cities presentation? Because we're going to cover more aspects of the company going forward. Yes, sir.
Just out of curiosity's sake, we're tied to CP&L or Progress Energy. Why are we not allowed to bid GEPCO or somebody else for that other 25%?
We are, and we do. What we do and what they want is long-term contracts. And the last contract we signed was in 2009. It goes through 2017. We have already gone out for bids. We have 8 bidders. And unfortunately, I can't tell you who they are because I've compromised it. We're in the process of evaluating them and looking at what's the lowest cost that we can get for the next contract. So we are doing that, and we're in the process of it.
Yeah,
we are doing that.
Thank you.
Hold on 1 second. Yes, sir.
Yeah, one of the things you just mentioned passed by pretty quickly was cap and trade. Now, that is going to be a real burden on us if that gets passed. And to me, it's one of the most silliest, asinine things that we do without Washington. What are you going to do about that?
Well, first of all, we really don't support cap and trade right now. Two reasons for that. For those of you that are not familiar with cap and trade, it's you theoretically you put a cap on your emissions and it's carbon dioxide. And carbon dioxide, every time you breathe, it's carbon dioxide. Every time you burn fuel, it's carbon dioxide. To the extent you can't reduce your carbon dioxide, you have to buy allowances, essentially pay a tax. There is no technology for carbon capture right now. The only technology that is available for carbon capture is what they call carbon sequestration, carbon capture and sequestration. So what we're going to do is we're going to take all the carbon dioxide that comes out of the smokestack, compress it into a liquid and pump it into the ground. Now, I've been in North Carolina over 30 years. We do not have the geological formation to do that. So the only way for the power agency to do that for the ownership in its coal plants is to pay the price for it. That price would raise by the 2030s. It would increase our power costs with no advantage whatsoever, 40%. So we don't support cap and trade in its current format.
I don't hear a lot of noise from the power plant operators, though, publicly saying how ridiculous it is and what a burden. I mean, we hear plenty of noise about, just like you said, about solar and wind. The costs are just, I believe, just like you said, 10 times what it is for coal fire. But we need somebody speaking up with a pretty
good voice. I can assure you they're very active in Washington. And we're working very closely with both Progress and Dominion Broad lobbyists also.
I guess I must be dense. Or either there's a black hole out there somewhere that seems to be sucking money. I look at your little bar graphs there as far as your expense. Expenses are no different for you guys that I see than they are for Progress Energy.
That's right.
Well, if your expenses are no greater than Progress Energy, if you own a minority share of Progress Energy, which means Progress Energy is paying the bulk of their debt on their plants, on these same plants, yet their rates are cheaper.
You raise an excellent point that I kind of glossed over. We own five plants. We own the last built, and they are a large portion of our portfolio. Progress Energy experienced the same cost overruns, but they have a much bigger fleet to spread their costs over. They have more nuclear plants that are older and already fully depreciated, and they have 19 other coal plants that we're not partners in. So what cost us is because we have ownership of the last most expensive house in the neighborhood. They have investment in the whole neighborhood, and so they're able to spread their costs out further than we are. And that's all it comes down to, is they're able to spread that debt over a larger base.
That takes care of where that black hole was.
Yes, ma'am.
Well, I understand everything that you said tonight, and it doesn't. At least I don't think.
Yeah, if you would.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you.
All right. I think most of us are here because our utility bills are costing us more than our rent, our mortgage, our medication, and we don't see an end to the price increase. So how are we going to survive? And that's really why I'm here.
Thank you for saying that. I should have pointed out as we were going through this, to run through numbers to show you that our system is similar in terms of its integrity to others does not mean that we don't understand that utility bills are too high. We understand that. It's just that as we go through the various places looking for solutions, we check off one that doesn't provide an opportunity for savings. Now, there's some places in the system where we can save money, but I can tell you, without giving away the rest of the presentation or what have you, the peak hour that you asked about earlier on is the answer to this. That's one half of our power bill. If we could save money there, it would be reflected in everybody's power bill, I think, Ken, to the tune of about 7%. Okay, he's got some information on that specifically, but also give us the opportunity to reduce rates. So you get kind of a double leg down. So what we're going to ask for in the end, and it starts with the light bulbs that you've got in the back, but it goes to every savings and conservation measure we can employ to try to cut into that peak hour. If we can do that, we can save money for you individually, and we can save money as a company and return that to you with lower rates.